Hey guys, so today we have quite a bit of storm cleanup to do. We had a really bad storm the other night and quite a few branches have fallen in this area. So kind of would like to get that cleaned up. Just a few small ones in this area, but I do have this large branch right here to clean up. This is the garden space that I pass on the way to the secret garden, which is back there. So I kind of want to get this area looking a bit more presentable. I have quite a few plants that I'm going to be adding in this space today. And this garden space is new. I curated this in the winter time, and I really only have this eastern snowball bush and this flower bed. So I'm going to get quite a few more plants in this flower bed. I would like to add some more mulch to this pathway. With the storm we had, some of the cardboard got exposed. So I'm going to be adding some mulch to this area. Maybe some edging to this flower bed. I'm not quite sure on that just yet. And I would like to get this pathway a bit more lined up. It's always kind of bothered me. So it doesn't line up correctly. So I'm thinking on, I do have another paver to try to space these out properly. Maybe curve this a bit more so it lines up a bit. Not exactly sure, but I will be doing that today as well. And I have these Danica arborvitaes I got from Home Depot for $15 on clearance. They were originally $30. I'm thinking about tucking them in this area. And I also have quite a few more plants I'm thinking about getting in this area today. We have two mini Malvette hydrangeas that I'm gonna stick in this flower bed as well. I believe this one right here, this planted, I believe this is a mini Malvette. I'm not 100% sure on that. I did get it from Home Depot and it wasn't labeled properly. So I did pick up two more. I'm pretty sure it's the same hydrangea, but not like 100% sure. I also have some Dark Tower Penstemon I would like to get in, and this Limity Lace Elderberry. I did get this on clearance at Lowe's. It did have leaves on it, but all the leaves did die back, and now it's sprouting some new growth, so I would like to get that in today as well. So let's go ahead and get started. I'm gonna start with these large branches and I'm just gonna toss these into the woods. A lot of acorns in this area as well. Virginia creeper. So, for the most part, this area has been cleaned up. A lot of the fallen branches are gone. I probably should have used my leaf blower though. I probably could have got up more of the leaves and the acorns that are in this area. But my main concern was the fallen branches, which are gone, so that's fine. I will be getting a garden broom though to be able to sweep off my steps and the pavers and a lot of the garden area, but I have not got that yet. So now we are going to address this pathway right here. The pavers don't line up and it's just annoying me. So what I think I'm gonna do, I think I'm gonna be removing, well, the middle paver. I think I'm gonna slide that a little bit to the right to kind of curve this pathway a bit before you go back into the secret garden area and plant the lemony lace elderberry on the corner where this tree is. So let's go ahead and get started with that. So what I'm thinking, I'm just going to slide this one over a bit. Let me see. I'm just gonna move these pavers real quick just to see what it will look like if I curved this a bit. So I ended up playing with this pathway a bit off camera. I just couldn't get it lined up the way I wanted. I ended up adding one more paver right there. I might have to go back to the store and get another one, but for the most part, I think I have it lined up the way I want. I will be adding a lot more mulch to this area though, to get them a little bit more snug into the ground and leveled a bit, because I had to move the pavers, the ones that lead all the way back to the secret garden area, because I had to space everything a bit more. So I am missing one now, so I might need to go get another one. But for the most part, I think these pavers line up the way I want. I just need to level them. But right now, we're gonna go ahead and get our lemony lace elderberry in the ground right there. I'm gonna plant it right here in this spot. So, that's in, nice and snug, covered up with a little bit of mulch. Hopefully, it does well in this area. Next, we're going to get in these arborvitaes. I'm going to place them along this path. I've already moved back the mulch a bit. Move it back a little bit more. This whole flower bed is covered in cardboard, so. But it's biodegradable. Shouldn't take long. Nope. See? So we've already cut through the cardboard, so it degrades pretty quickly. Bit of glass right there. Just gonna remove these large chunks, make it easier to dig. So right now these are gonna go over here. I'm not sure if they're gonna be staying over here, but right now I think they will be good over here. More glass. Cute little jar right here. So if you're new to the channel, this property is covered in trash from the previous owner, and quite a bit of it is buried. I have dug up antique bottles in this flower bed before. When I first started creating it, I was planting some daffodils and dug up like 4 antique bottles out of the ground. So I guess this area is covered in it too. Even though this whole area was wooded, wasn't even able to get back here. I had to clear all this out, so. But apparently they managed to get big trash in the ground back here as well. So right now I'm just loosening up the roots to this, and it's gonna get tucked in right here. Once again, got these on clearance for $15 at Home Depot, which is very rare that they actually put anything on clearance, the one I go to. But I also managed to snag 2 Checkmark Trilogy Arborvitaes. No, Checkmark Trilogy with Gilas and these Danica Arborvitaes. And they all were clearance for another glass, piece of glass. They all were clearance, $15. I really need to be careful when I dig in the ground and use my hands and stuff, because there's always glass in the ground. But I'm gonna tuck this in, get it nice and snug. Now I'm gonna tuck this next one right beside it. And I've already cleared back the mulch. And I had a lot of cardboard in this area, but it's already degraded, so I don't know, maybe I should have put it a bit thicker in this flower bed, but it looks like it was only one layer, but it was a lot of cardboard there. Thank you. the Danica arborvitaes are in. I could trim off the brown tips, but I'm not worried about that at the moment. I think they're gonna be good in this area. I like the way they look along the path. So now I think we are going to get in our mini Mauvette hydrangeas. So I believe that this is a mini Mauvette hydrangea, but it wasn't labeled properly at Home Depot. I have one on each side of the arbor, so I'm kind of going to continue the mini Mauvettes down here, like a row with plenty of room in between them. So I'm going to plant these. I believe this is the spot that I want them in. So let's go ahead and get these in the ground. So I'm going to stick these over here, whether they end up moving at a later date, you know, that's fine. I'm not sure. The Eastern Snowball tree will be limbed up, so these will get enough room, and I'm sure it will get enough sun as well. So I'm just going to tuck them in here for now. Many Mauvette hydrangeas are in, and the Danica arborvitaes are also in. So now I'm thinking I'm going to be laying a few pavers in this flower bed to try to edge it up a bit. And I'm going to be using the ones I made. So let's go ahead and get started with these. The edging is in. I don't have enough to do this whole entire flower bed yet because I do make these and it takes time. But when I do, I will finish the other side of the flower bed. So right now, I think I'm going to be adding a bit mulch. I'm not sure if I'm going to be planting the Dark Tower Penstemon in this flower bed just yet. I might, but I want to let this marinate a bit to see if I like what's going on here. So I'm gonna go ahead and spread some mulch. So I'm gonna have to move these pavers a bit to raise them up the height of the other pavers and to add a bit more mulch in this area as well. Raise the ground up a bit because the pavers aren't the same height. Thank you. So I added a bit of mulch to this pathway to get the pavers in a little bit more leveled and snug. And I think it looks great. I did add a bit more to the pathway over here, but not much. Just enough to cover up the cardboard. I'll do a better job at that once I get the edging in here so I can get the proper shape. And I probably will add a lot more once the edging is in. But for now, that's how it's going to be. Let's go ahead and get the Dark Tower penstemon in. I thought about it, and I think I'm just going to go ahead and plant them over here. It wasn't my original thought, but I think they will look great with some reblooming yellow daylilies. So I'm going to go ahead and tuck them in right over here. So I'm going to do a trio of three in this area right here. And hopefully I can get them paired with some reblooming yellow daylilies. I'm going to stand back, see if I like how that looks. This one's going to move over a little bit right here. So let's go ahead and get these in the ground. I think I'm digging up another bottle. Yep. This little one. I have no idea what it is. So I ran into a bit of greenbrier over here, which is this vine right here, and I really do need to get this up, but I really don't want to tear up the pathway. Well, it broke, so since it broke, I'm just gonna cut it and try to keep it. Also pulled up some glass while I was doing that, and a bit of plastic, so. Not sure what that is. The Dark Towers Penstemon is in. I'm hoping to pair it with some reblooming yellow daylilies. I do have going bananas in the garden. It's not doing too well in the spot that it is in, so I might relocate it to this flower bed. I'm not sure. And we also got our Danica arborvitaes along this curve. A little bit of winter interest. Our two mini mauvette hydrangeas also, so we kind of have like a row of three. I'm going to move this one closer to the arbor, give the penstemon a bit more room. And we also got our Limity Lace elderberry in as well. I added quite a bit more mulch to this pathway because I had to rearrange quite a bit of the pavers. So I like how everything turned out in this area. The eastern snowball bush does get rather large. I will be limbing it up, so I think everything will have enough room and enough sunlight back here. So thank you guys for joining me on this project, and I hope again to see you in the next one. Thanks. Bye.